Have you set the right goals for yourself? It's time for a new, smart way of thinking.
Yet another fitness band, or is it? Unlike almost every other fitness band, wind for your wrist, this one needs no charger. Interested? Well, let's find out if the Garmin Vivo Fit is offering you anything more than charging convenience.
If you haven't tried kickboxing yet, you should start now.
From the ridiculously absurd to the scientifically supported, there are a number of diets coming in every year, all promising the same thing: get slim quick. So how serious you should be about all the hype surrounding these fad diets?
Have you been setting fitness goals for yourself in the past that you failed to achieve? Many times, we don't reach the goals that we set out for ourselves simply because we lack strategy. So smart strategy can actually spell success for us. SMART, which stands for specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, and time-bound. Let's take a look at one of the most common fitness goals that people quote from around the world. And let's see how we can make this goal smarter.
I want to lose weight.
This is the most common goal, most commonly quoted by any and everyone who steps into the gym. But it's going to remain wishful thinking unless we incorporate a few smart details into it. Let's look at the specific aspect of SMART. What are you specifically going to do to lose weight? A combination of cardio and strength at the gym? A yoga class in the park before work? Cutting down on your desserts? Say you choose the gym routine. Now, the new goal is...
I want to lose weight and I'll do that with strength and cardio in the gym.
That's better, but still not good enough. Let's get in the measurable aspect of SMART. How much weight do you plan to lose? 2 kgs? 6 kgs? 10 kgs? Health parameters advise that healthy weight loss must not be more than 0.5 to 1 kg per week and no more than that. Now, we have a new goal.
I'll lose 2 to 4 kgs and I'll do that with strength and cardio in the gym.
Excellent. Now we're getting somewhere, but we need a lot more detailing. So let's start by looking at the time-bound aspects. How many times a week will you be going to the gym? And how much time will you spend on the workout? Also, do you have an end date in mind for this project? And then there is the R of SMART. You have to ask yourself, is this goal relevant to me? Or is this something that is an aspiration that I neither need nor really want? And finally, you must double check on the plan to make sure that it is achievable with the workout, the diet, and the time frame that you have chosen. So now, keeping all these aspects in mind, we finally have something.
I will lose 2 to 4 kg in 30 days by doing a 60-minute strength and cardio routine in the gym, 5 times a week. I want to lose weight because it will keep me healthy.
Brilliant. Now that's a SMART goal. And in 30 days, you will actually be able to measure your success. And just in case you've not been able to achieve your goal, you'll know exactly where you went wrong. So always remember to break down your goals into SMART goals. The S of SMART stands for specific, which means that your goal should be clear and easy to understand. The M of SMART stands for measurable. Making your goal measurable means adding a number. The A of SMART stands for achievable. Before you can add a number, you have to know how high or how low you want to go. The goal should not be too extreme nor too easy, but it should definitely be attainable. The R of SMART stands for relevant. Set goals that are important to where you are in your life right now. Don't set a goal that someone else is pressuring you to attain, because that just simply isn't motivating enough. The T of SMART stands for time bound. Include an end point to your goal. Knowing that you have a deadline motivates you to get started and to keep on going. Give it a thought. Break down your fitness goal into a SMART one and make it achievable.
Fad diet feeds on the insecurity of those with the weight issues. And it's easy to believe when the whole world is swearing by them. But before you embark on the new diet adventure, let's find out about different kinds of diets.
Fad diets are destined to fail. And there are a lot of reasons why they never work in the long run, and therefore shouldn't be encouraged in the first place. Let's take a close look at four popular diet fads. The baby food diet. This diet encourages one to consume baby food to lose weight. Dieters are supposed to replace their usual breakfast and lunch with baby food and have only one well-rounded adult meal for dinner. Seems perfect by the looks of it, but baby food is made for babies. It cannot meet an adult's nutritional needs. Part of what signals our brains that we are satiated is the act of chewing. Baby food requires no chewing. Also, baby food doesn't allow for much variety and therefore becomes difficult to sustain this diet after a while. The blood type diet. This diet advocates eating or avoiding foods depending on your blood type. For instance, the diet recommends that those with blood type A should eat a vegetarian diet and steer clear of meat to avoid bloating. Blood type O's should eat meat and seafood, but avoid grains, legumes, and corn to prevent weight gain. Well, cutting out meat completely and going vegetarian may help people with type A blood to lose some weight and eat lesser. But if you have been a meat eater all your life, it could be difficult to switch to a vegetarian lifestyle all of a sudden. And if you can't sustain a diet, even an awesome one, it's not going to work in the long run. The grapefruit diet. The grapefruit diet has been around for quite a while now and is based on the claim that grapefruit has fat-burning properties. According to this diet, you need to consume half a grapefruit at every meal for at least 10 to 12 days. The diet is also quite restrictive. No high-carb and starchy foods like beans, corn, and potatoes. Since these foods contribute to water gain, dieters may notice some weight loss thanks to less water retention. Also, the fruit has fiber content, so it may help fill you up before eating a meal. The thing with all restrictive diets is that you will definitely see a weight loss. In the case of grapefruit diet, it restricts carbs, so you will see a lot of water weight loss. But once you reintroduce carbs, the weight comes right back. The paleo diet. Eat like a caveman and get fit. That's the idea behind this diet. This diet promotes eating protein and fiber-rich foods to aid weight loss. While the diet does encourage eating organic, wholesome, and homemade foods, it restricts dairy, grains, and legumes, food groups that we know are good for us. The paleo diet is a proponent of using coconut oil and coconut milk, but these are high in saturated fat, which may not fit well in your sedentary lives today. The good thing about diets is that they make us aware about what we're eating, but most diets are just quick fixes that do not work in the long run. Also, most of these diets exclude essential nutrients and are difficult to follow for the rest of your life.
If you're seriously considering a new weight loss plan, and if you're feeling unsure, seek the advice of the physician or registered dietitian. They would be able to help you the best.